Hey everyone, Scott Church here, Category1Games.com. Today I want to take a look at and we're going to talk about the X-Men toys from Toy Biz from the mid-90s. Now these were really cool toys. I always kept these collector cards that they came on. The toy, you can see the outline of where it sat and it's plastic. But I just want to show you this. So this was the first run of X-Men. Now, this was released in the early 90s, 1991. I personally was 10 years old, and this was a big push. I mean, you had the Marvel trading card series going on. You had really cool things happening with the X-Men cartoon about the launch and on Fox, and this was just so cool. So it gave you, like, it showed you the other characters being released, a little backstory on the figure. So this is Colossus, what the figure did, and then it even gave you 50% off on comics. And I actually used this years later because some of these didn't have an expiration date. Like this one does, right? Offer expires July 1992. Some of them didn't actually have an expiration date. So you could use them years later. It's pretty crazy. Like here's a Wolverine from that first series. So this was series one, right? So you can tell these are $4.97. You know, go to your local Walmart now and take a look at how much figures cost like this. They're going to be about $10 to $20. And you can often find these like two for $5 in the holiday seasons. So it's really cool. Like here's Storm. This was a harder to get figure because women figures, girl figures, were harder to find because they produce less, thinking that boys would not want to buy them. Now, if you're making your team of X-Men, you've got to have Storm. Storm was a big part of it at the time. Now, it's interesting too because Cyclops and Archangel were no longer on the X-Men at this time. Cyclops here had laser light eyes. Archangel was cool. It had his big wings and it had like two little missiles on each end of his wings. And so it was pretty. Magneto had magnetic little metal parts that could attach to his body at different spots because he had magnets inside of him. Kind of a cool thing. Apocalypse had like a big pen, which didn't really make sense. And then his legs extended down and his arms extended out, if I'm not mistaken. Actually his arms didn't, it was just his legs. You can actually see it in this picture where his legs just go down and he has this big like pen, which didn't make any sense. Juggernaut was cool, except he had like this like battering ram thing, which I don't know, power punch action, and then snap the battering ram onto his shoulders and roll him forward. I believe he had wheels on the bottom of his feet, so he kind of rolled. But he didn't really need a battering ram because he was the battering ram. So then the next series of X-Men came out, and it was, like, much better. And they already had these Marvel series out, and I'll talk about those here in a minute. But they had, like, electronic talking. They had X-Force was in the next line, and then they did a whole new run of X-Men. And these X-Men were really well done, and they had the gold and blue old style uniforms that were kind of popular at this time in X-Men with Jim Lee bringing these back in, like, what was it, the 270s, right, of Uncanny X-Men. So like when they go off into space and fight the Shi'ar, they're using these uniforms, and it has more classic villains like Mr. Sinister, Sauron, Sabretooth. Anyways, really cool. Gambit had a kick and he had a cool leather coat, which really wasn't leather, it was like plastic, and a bow staff. Banshee had the cool wings, which I can't imagine Banshee being a hot figure at this time, but he had like the wings that went up and you could blow on this little spot on his back. There was like a whistle. This was the original Iceman. This was actually really hard to find and had some value to it. If you put him in a freezer, he'll be covered in a fake icicles that kind of light up because of the paint. Sabretooth had like one of those things like battle damage He-Man and Skeletor had where it like spun around. I think he had the same thing on his stomach, and he also had this little like weapon that didn't really make sense. Mr. Sinister had a little button you press where his chest lit up, and that was about it. Sinister was just like, oh, and his eyes lit up too. But Sinister was just such a cool toy to get, and at this time he's still mysterious, only having been in Inferno. You didn't really have a lot more on him until Executioner's Song. Sauron was cool. A big pterodactyl type figure, which was pretty neat. Bishop, I think, is this series three, I want to say? Let's take a look and see. Yeah, so this was This is actually the next series was Bishop, and he had two guns, which was really cool. So you had X-Force's original series, and the X-Force had a series two, which included this run. X-Force's original series was this one and this one. Now X-Men series three was this bottom row. So you had a much better Apocalypse. You had a cool Omega Red, which was popular at the time, and randomly Tusk, one of Apocalypse's agents, the Dark Riders. Strong Guy came out, which was an interesting pick. Like the only one so far from like X Factor. Wolverine, fifth edition. This was like Spy Wolverine, which was big in what was the X-Men like four through six, where it introduced Omega Red, whereas like Wolverine being a spy at that time. And then here was Omega Red, which was actually a really cool figure. It had these little tendrils that came out of the bottom of his arm that you could move forward and back. And it was really true to X-Men at the time. This Apocalypse was cool. It had like different arms you could put on. The one with the chainsaw didn't really make sense, but at least the big snapping arm did, which was actually really cool to put on. And the figure itself, the sculpt was really nice. It's the best Apocalypse at that time for sure, especially compared to the first one. Tusk was, they're supposed to do more Dark Riders. I believe there was at least one or two more. One was actually previewed on like a lot of magazines at the time to be coming out. And I believe there's a second one, and it didn't. Tusk was cool. It had like a back piece where this little figure was in it and it like popped out. I actually really like this figure. You can see like kind of what I'm talking about here, where the back piece went back and this little minifigure's in there. I really wish they had made more of the Dark Riders to give more villains for the X-Men to fight against. Here's Professor X in his wheelchair. And it had little flip-up things where he had a gun, which was like, wait, I've never seen that in the comic. Brood was a really cool figure, just a giant alien-looking thing. This was the next series, which had Professor X, Cyclops, Ahab randomly, Longshot randomly, another better Sabretooth, and a Brood. And then X-Force didn't get an update on this series. So here's Ahab. X-Force's original series had, like, here's a Deadpool, which was pretty sweet. This was actually, was this the first? This was the first Deadpool. Again, $4.99. Really cool Deadpool figure. Here he is there. Here's this comic book thing I was saying. Send your name and address along with the title and check payable to Marvel Comics. You get Uncanny X-Men or X-Factor. Allow 10 weeks. There's no end date on this. So I remember I was in college. So I mean, this was 10 years later. I was in college and I actually sent one of these in and they sent me comics. It was awesome. Deadpool had a knife in one hand that would retract back in, and then he had a sword on his back. It was actually a really cool figure. You got a Rogue finally. You know, it's funny they made a Banshee before they made a Rogue. So like, here's the next series of, oh, here's the next series of X-Force. Here you had Sunspot, Shatterstar, Richter. Richter was cool because it had a little button you shook on his back or like spun on his back, and he would shake. It was pretty cool. Cable, Quark randomly. And Pyro. And it's surprising they put Pyro in X-Force. I mean, he'd been in like X-Force 4 through 6 or 7. But that was it. He was mainly an X-Men villain. But here's X-Men's next set. They had Silver Samurai, Morph, who was on the TV series, is why they put him in. A nice Beast. Random should have been like X-Factor. Trevor Fitzroy, and then a Robot Wolverine. And then they re-released Iceman. They re-released a Nightcrawler. Sauron again. Storm. Mr. Sinister with a different back. Like kind of covering a Weapon X Wolverine and a new Magneto, and Magneto had a gun. Yeah, it was really lame. So here's Storm with a power punch. Sorry, Rogue with a power punch, and I don't even see her on this list, which is interesting because normally they would cover those characters, right? They put them on the back here so you can see them. Like here's Beast. He had a flip action thing that didn't really work, but it was cool to have a Beast figure. This was cool to get Bonebreaker. He was the only one of this group that you actually got. Again, it's strange that they didn't include them on the back. Sinaka, who was a Magneto follower, he's not on the back either. This was the next set, Corsair. And by this time, I was basically out of these. This was 1994. I was 13 at the time, and this was like no longer cool to me. The cartoon had kind of worn on. They were doing this Dark Phoenix saga. You had Warstar, Corsair, Wolverine, like eight at that time. Phoenix, which was actually a cool figure. Gladiator. X-Force had Extreme, Killspree randomly, and Comcast, both worthless figures. Same with Slayback. Another Cable 5, and then Warpath 2, which was actually a cool Warpath. But anyways, I was basically done at that time. Here's a Shatter Star, the original one. Now this is the first series of X-Force, as Arnes just went up with his swords, and I took that. I took the coupon. Same thing with Forearm, original Rob Liefeld. His arms just kind of rotated. He had four arms. That's the gist of it. This was Kane. This was his second iteration. It was based off of Cable, like one and two, is designed for that, the mini series. Then here's another Cable based off of, I believe, Executioner's Song Cable. Nope, here's like around that time, Cable. Grizzly was a backup character and part of Cable's six pack. Anyways, this was a cool Cannonball. It came with like this little launcher thing you put them on, and you just like push it, and the figure like fell forward. It was really lame, but that was supposed to like show he's blasting. Yeah, Cruel was a minor character in X-Force. Really lame. He just had like a big, I don't know, ponytail thing off of the top of his forehead, that had like a ball on the end of it. It was pathetic. This was a much better Shatterstar. This was the updated design, I believe, that Tony Daniel came up with around X-Force, what, 26, 28, 29, something like that. And it had the two swords. I liked this design. That was a cool Shatterstar. Same with this. This was a cool Sunspot figure. Same with the cool Richter figure. They did a really good job with these. And then the Pyro was awesome to get. I wish it would have made a Blob or the rest of like Freedom Force or Brotherhood of Evil Mutants. And you could kind of tie him in with that newer Brotherhood of Evil Mutants with Sauron, but still, you're missing a lot. Mojo is a really cool and creepy looking figure. Just this very big blobbish character with a big tail and little tentacles for feet. A really cool figure. And then this was the updated Warpath, which was cool. And then Extreme, which was supposed to be the third Summers Brothers, and then it wasn't. Now, this is the original Marvel Superheroes. Now, this Dr. Octopus was like a sweet, sweet figure. It had these different ones. I would say the best one for playability wise was this Dr. Octopus, because on each one, each of his arms, he had four total, two on each side. One had a little grabbing one, and one had a suction cup. Now, these were just so cool because it like he could stick to walls or like to glass. Like, actually, a really cool figure. He could hold your other figures in his arms. It was really cool. Captain America came with a shooting shield instead of just like a shield. Anyways, Spider-Man had like real web crawler action. It just had like a thing in the front of him that made it so it really wasn't as playable, and his hands were like really posed weird. So yeah, I mean, these were like $4 at the time, but they like this one really wasn't as playable. This Venom was actually really cool. It came with like ooze that you could like stick in his back and then like push it, and it would like squirt out of his chest. So that was a cool one. Green Goblin actually was really sweet. It came with a pumpkin that he could throw, as well as his glider, which was really actually pretty cool. That was a good figure. Punisher, you could put cap guns, like the little caps in his back, and then pop them like he was firing. Which is funny that like, you know, you think about today, like giving a kid like a figure where he's shooting guns. Anyways, just funny. Silver Surfer. You've got him, and he had a board, and the board had wheels on it, so you could kind of wheel around, which is pretty sweet. This was the second Venom, and it had a cool flicking tongue action on his back, and the figure and the sculpt was just really well designed. And this looks like the Marvel Series 2, like, card, where he's, like, kind of, like, dancing really quietly. And I love that they put, like, artwork from the comic on the back here, right? So, like, here's Venom, when we will kill Spider-Man, right? Yeah, just really cool. And then you've got classic Doctor Doom. And this figure was actually pretty lame. He had like this little spinning shield, power-driven weapons. Yeah, it was like a shield, and you just like spun this little knob on the back of him, and it did that. At this time, this was pretty cool. You actually had like the older series. Like, Hulk had a rock and like a piece of metal pipe. Here's the second, like Venom, like a really nice Silver Surfer. It was really shiny. Deathlok randomly, which was kind of a weird figure. And then you had like the Fantastic Four side, where you had all the Fantastic Four. Visible Woman was actually really rare, and went for a lot more money. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this look back at these Marvel and X-Men card backs, because to me, I thought these were always really cool. It's just something neat. I kept these for like all the different toys I would get, because I just thought these were cool and I'd want to look at them later on, kind of like I'm doing now. Thanks everyone for watching. This is Scott with Category What Gabes. Please like and subscribe to this video. I would really appreciate it. Thanks, everyone.